Christingle means Christ light and signifies peace and goodwill. In our service today, we will use Christingle to celebrate Jesus, God with us, the light of the world. We will hear the song which Mary sang when God chose her to bear his son. And we will think about the different ways in which Jesus is with us all today. But first, let us light our Advent candles. What is the meaning of the Advent wreath? Well, the Advent wreath is shaped in a perfect round circle, symbolizing the eternity of God. The green plants that you see here, beautifully displayed and arranged, symbolizes continuous life. Can anyone tell me how many candles there are? Hands up or shout it out. How many candles are there around this wreath? Be bold. Oh, God. Yes. Well done. Well done. There are four. You're absolutely right. We've got three purple and we've got one pink. The first candle represents hope. The first one represents hope. Jesus reminds us that God loves us. As long as we have hope, we can keep on trying to do better. The second candle represents peace. We pray for peace for ourselves, for one another, and for the world. The third candle, which we shall light next week on Gaudete Sunday or Rose Sunday, represents joy. It represents joy, the joy that Jesus brought to the world. And the fourth candle represents love. In Jesus, we see that God loves us all. The challenge is for us is to bring that love, not just at Christmas time, but every single day through the year. That's our big challenge. So now we shall light the candles. Well, we shall light only two. We shall light the candle of hope and the candle of peace. It's the build-up to Christmas. Oops. There we go. There we go. I'm going to walk slowly with this. Go out. So the candle. Came down from heaven and entered our world as a child, born of the Virgin Mary.
Open our eyes to see your light today.
Lord Jesus, from the crib to the cross, you stood among the people who had the least and suffered the most.
Open our eyes to see your light today.
Lord Jesus, you promised that when two or three are gathered in your name, you are there in the midst of them.
Open our eyes to see your light today.
Jesus is indeed the light of the world. But we use many different kinds of lights to help us see in the dark, don't we? I have a bag here full of lights. Okay. A light bulb. Well, we could be here all afternoon saying all the things that a light helps us to see in the dark. Okay, a light bulb. about a candle. A candle. Do you know, I love candles. We think we all do now in our homes, don't we? But when I light my candle in my home, it helps me see Jesus more clearly. So when I light my candle at home, it helps me see Jesus more clearly. On Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then I come to church on Sunday, and I see the lights in church as well. This one says peace on the front, but it's quite lovely, that. Anyway, there we go. The next one we have, does anybody ride a bike? Who rides a bike? You do. Good. Anybody else ride a bike? Yes, you, oh, and some parents as well. All right, great stuff. Wow. Are you allowed to ride your bike in the dark? No. Well, if you were, you would need one of these, wouldn't you? You would need one of these to help you see in the dark, to see where you are going. Yeah. Okay, just pop that there. What about a lighthouse? What does a lighthouse, help you see? Anybody? What does a lighthouse help you see? Yes? The sea! Yes, well done, the sea. The lighthouse helps you to see the sea. Good, well done, helps you see that all is well on the sea. Each of these lights has a purpose, but we are looking at a different kind of light this afternoon, aren't we? We're looking at a different kind of light. We're looking at Christ's light, because Christ's light is a revealing light. Christ reveals God to us because he's God's Son. He can reveal God to us. His light is a saving light. Just like a lighthouse saves ships from being shipwrecked in the darkness, so Christ saves us from all that is wrong and brings us back to God. And lastly, Christ's light is a guiding light. Just as a bike light shows us the right path forward, so Christ is our guide throughout life to show us the right way forward. He will bring a light. He will bring to light things now hidden in darkness and disclose all the secrets of our hearts. In his light, we confess our sins, all the things that we have done wrong. So let us pray for all the times we have sinned and we have turned a blind eye to God's light in our lives, asking for forgiveness. So just take a little moment now and just reflect on those things that you would like to say sorry for. The responses are in bold type that you'll see now on the screen. Lord Jesus, as we prepare to greet your coming into the world, we confess that we often forget the real meaning of Christmas.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, light of the world, we confess that we have not shone as light in our turn, leading others to you.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, born in a stable, we confess that we are not prepared to meet you and too often push you into a corner of our lives.
Lord, have mercy.
May May God love the world so much that he sent his Son to be our Saviour. Forgive us our sins and make us holy to serve him in the world through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. And now we have our first reading from the book of Isaiah, read by Mrs. Palmer.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. They lived in a land of shadows, but now light is shining on them. You have given them great joy, Lord. You have made them happy. They rejoice in what you have done, as people rejoice when they harvest grain or when they divide captured wealth. For you have broken the yoke that burdened them and the rod that beat their shoulders. You have defeated the nation that oppressed and exploited your people, just as you defeated the army of Midian long ago. The boots of the invading army and all their bloodstained clothing will be destroyed by fire. A child is born to us, a son is given to us, and he will be our ruler. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. His royal power will continue to grow. His kingdom will always be at peace. He will rule as King David's successor, basing his power on right and justice from now until the end of time. The Lord Almighty is determined to do all this. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us stand and sing 370, Joy to the World. Now we have the second reading, which is the introduction to the Magnificat. And this is Joy. Yes, okay.
Many years, many hundreds of years, to the time before Jesus had been born.
The world was waiting in darkness to see what God would do. There were so many ways in which people were cruel. Little ways and big ways, from the smallest acts of unkindness to the biggest wars.
The world was waiting in darkness to see what God would do.
There were so many ways in which people were forgetful. People with food forgot the hungry. People with shelter forgot the homeless. People with friends forgot the lonely.
The world was waiting in darkness to see what God would do.
Some people said, God is asleep and we can do whatever we want. Some people said, no, God is angry and will come to punish us with his great power.
What happened next surprised everyone.
God was not asleep. But God did not come to take revenge and punish everyone. Instead, he sent his son Jesus to live among them, shining the light of his love into the darkness of sin and injustice.
And who did God choose to be Jesus' mother?
God chose Mary, a young woman from a poor family. Mary, a young woman from Nazareth, a town of little importance.
God chose a person and a place which everyone else had overlooked.
God sent the angel Gabriel to tell Mary the good news. She would be the mother of his son.
Mary was surprised and confused. What could all this mean? She thought and prayed and read the scriptures.
At last she understood. And Mary sang to praise God for sending Jesus to the world. The song is written down in Luke's Gospel.
Mary's song is often called the Magnificat. We are going to join together to say it now.
Please turn, look at the screen or use your service sheet and join in with the words in bold type.
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. He has looked with favour on his lowly servant.
From this day, all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
He has mercy on those who fear him from generation to generation.
He has shown the strength of his arm and has scattered the proud in their conceit.
He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and lifted up the lowly.
He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty.
He has come to the aid of his servant Israel to remember his promise of mercy.
The promise made to our ancestors, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
So stay standing as we sing from our hymn book on the screen there, 901, if you have your service sheet. This little light of mine.
Can I just say, Debbie, I know people didn't really know that last one. I picked it because we thought we were doing it in the carriage service and something like that. But everybody that's been at St Thomas's, even though we haven't sung for quite a while, should know this one. So, yeah, people are not even going to be singing. I feel a bit embarrassed.
I know. We'll sing it, won't we? We'll back her up, not we'll sing.
Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
little light of mine is my Christingle. It's a potato. I couldn't find a tangerine. But they don't have to be tangerines or oranges, do they? They can be anything. Mine happens to be a spud. And it's got foil wrapped round it. It's got a light in the middle. You can't see it, it's a tea light. It's in the middle, it is there. It's got a ribbon, and it's got four sticks, and it's got cheese and grapes, because I like cheese and grapes. I love the combination. I did try putting Christmas cake off, but it just crumbled. It had fruit in it, but anyway, enough about my Christingle. Can I see your Christingles? You've got lots of sweets on yours, have you? At least I've got a little bit of fruit, but they look lovely. They do look lovely. Can anybody remember from last year what the orange tangerine or spud represents? What was that? I heard something. Go on, say it. The world. Yes, well done you. Good. And what about the candle in the middle? What does that represent? I'm coming. What did you say? Light of the world. Good girl. That's wonderful. And what about the foil? Sometimes we miss out the foil. What about the foil? It reflects God's love, God's light to the world, isn't it? That's what we should do. And what about the red ribbon that goes around the orange of the tangerine?
Is that the blood of Jesus?
The blood of Jesus. Well done. Yes, shed for our sins, absolutely right. And the four cocktail sticks? The lady who plays the piano will know. Yes, I think she does. How do you know what the four sticks are for? Yes, just the sticks, please.
That's a change.
The four seasons, yes. Spring, summer, autumn, and winter. And what about the fruit and the sweets that you've got lots of? What about them? What about the fruit and the cheese and the grapes and the sweets? What do they represent? All good things from the world that God gives us. Your mum and dad love you so much that they want to give you good things. Well, our Heavenly Father loves us so much, He wants to give us good things. Yeah? Even sweets He wants to give us. Yes, He does. So I'm going to put mine here, so I'm going to light mine when you light yours. Serious moment, just for a minute, before we light our candles. Let us remember that a Christingle service raises money for the Children's Society, who are perhaps facing the toughest times in our world. Right now, there are children in desperate need of help, as we shall see as we watch this short film on the screen. Thank you for sharing the light of Christingle and helping disadvantaged children and young people in the darkest situations. We've all been through a lot over the last 2 years, and unfortunately young people have been some of the hardest hit by the pandemic. For the young carers who have been shouldered with more responsibility than ever, the young people who have experienced devastating effects on their mental health, or the missing children who have nowhere to shelter for the night. We need your kindness more than ever. Together, we can renew the hope inside these vulnerable children and provide the safety net they so urgently need. Your Christingle donations will help run vital services across the country, helping children through
went to work counselling and dedicated to agenda workers. You can guide the most vulnerable children to a brighter future. The kindness of Christinglers like you will help bring hope and optimism to the lives of young people. Please give what you can today and let children in this country know how much they matter.
We can help, indeed we can. We can donate, either by bringing back the filled collection candles to school or church, donating at this service, there's a plate at the back, or via the donation link, which will be on both Facebook, yes, and YouTube, with the video of the service, and on the church and school websites as well. So we can help. Well, now it's time to light our Christingles. So please move to the side of the church. Take nothing with you, just your Christingle. And be very careful as you stand around the church to keep a little gap between you. And whilst you're doing that, would the eye fabric come forward? And Phineas, please. To take your place behind the microphone. Thank you. Right. Okay. Thank you.
Lord Jesus, I stretch out my hands and receive this gift, and I hold it tight because it is mine. My Christingle, light, fruit, sweet, colour, but so much more precious than this. I hold in my hands a picture of your love. I imagine all the other special things I might hold. Lord Jesus, help me to remember those with little I can't hold, especially other children who don't have enough to eat but are safely to live. Today, as I hold my Christingle and remember you, I pray that you would make me someone like you, who will reach out my open hands to give and love like you do. Amen.
Amen. Lord Jesus, you told your disciples, you are the light of the world. Please bless these Christingles which we hold, that they may be signs of your love. Bless us, that we may be lights in the dark places of life. Bless the Children's Society, its staff and volunteers, that they may bring light, hope and happiness to children, young people and families who face particular darkness or need. May we all shine as lights in the world to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Right, time to light the candles. Yes. Oh, just come down and we'll have our intercessions.
Now it's time for our prayers. Wait a sec if it's not on. Sorry. Dave, have we got microphones on? All of them? Let them turn on.
Now it is time for our prayers. You may want to keep your eyes open and look at your Christingle to help with your thoughts and reflections. We respond to the words, Lord, in your mercy, is hear our prayer.
The orange in our Christingle represents the world. We pray for our world that people may learn to live peacefully without conflict. Help us to work towards peace in our lives and spread that peace into the lives of others. We pray for all who are sad, lonely or frightened, for all who have been forced to leave their own homes to seek refuge in places which are strange to them. Lord, in your mercy.
The cocktail sticks remind us of the four seasons, spring, summer, autumn and winter. Thank you for the beautiful world you have given us. Please help us to learn not to spoil it. We think of all those for whom the winter cold means only illness, fear or death. We pray for all who are homeless at this time, both adults and children. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
The sweetened fruit on the cocktail sticks remind us of all the good things that we have, which have come from you. Thank you for the sun and the rain which make the crops grow. We pray for all those who are hungry for any reason. While we are enjoying the presents this Christmas, help us remember that there are many children who will receive nothing. Be with them this Christmas, Lord. Lord, in your mercy.
The candle reminds us that Jesus Christ is the light of the world, a light no darkness can quench, a light which eternally shines and brings hope. We pray for anyone we know who is ill and ask that this light may shine on them and bring them the power of your healing love. In a moment of silence, let us think about those we care about and hold them up to you. Lord, in your mercy,
us of Good Friday when Jesus died at Easter time. We know that it is sad when people die. Please comfort those who are sad because a relative or friend has died, and please look after children whose parents have died. Be with them all, Lord, and give them love and strength to carry on. Lord, in your mercy.
The temple reflects the light of the candle. We pray that we may reflect the light of Christ to others by living as Jesus taught us, by helping others and in everything we do and say. Please help us to think about all these things as we go out from here so that we may reflect Christ's light in the world always. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen. We'll finish our prayers by all saying the Lord's Prayer together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Well, we had to blow out our candles now, but blow them out very, very carefully, please. And be mindful not to blow your candle in the direction of anybody else's face. Please, that horrid woman still around. Please. Thank you. Thank you so much. That was lovely. Thank you, Kate. serve is so special. Thank you so, so much to Mum and Dad, family, friends, Mrs. Palmer, especially the children. Thank you so, so much. I remember last year when we were not allowed to sing. Father Chris sang, "Next year it will be different. You'll sing." And he was right. Father Chris was absolutely right. Isn't that wonderful? So now we come to our blessing. May the Lord open our eyes to see the face of Jesus in all who are in need. May the Lord open our hearts to welcome and care for each of God's children. May the Lord pour out his Spirit upon us all, that we may light up the world through the love of Jesus Christ. And may Almighty God bless us and watch over us this day and always. Amen. Go in peace and in the light of Christ.
Thanks
be to God. Amen.
Amen.
Hold the magic gene.
Well, we're going to do that on Saturday.